Good morning. Today is Monday, the feast of St. Mary Magdalene. Let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and
on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you,
we bless you,
we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King,
O God, almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One.
You alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son entrusted Mary Magdalene before all others with announcing the great joy of the resurrection, grant, we pray, that through her intercession and example, we may proclaim the living Christ and come to see him rejoicing, reigning in your glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he told her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we celebrate the feast of St. Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene is often referred to as the Apostle of the Apostle. As we hear in today's Gospel, she is the first to know that Jesus has risen and the first person whom Jesus speaks to. She is the one who takes this great news of the resurrection to the apostles. One of the interesting points in today's Gospel is that Mary turns towards Jesus twice. She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I do not know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. The first time she puts her focus on Jesus, she doesn't recognize him. She thinks it was the gardener, but then Jesus speaks. Jesus says to her, "Mary." She turns. If she was already facing him, why would she need to turn around again? The turning here is not physical. It's a turning of the heart. Her understanding is the turning. Her spiritual knowledge is her turning. The first time she turns towards Jesus, she sees a gardener. Her anxiety, her fears are at the forefront. She is consumed with concern. But the second time she turns around, she sees Jesus. What does she call him? Teacher. It is much easier for us to turn the body than it is to turn our hearts. We can take ourselves to Mass. We celebrate the sacraments. We go through all the motions, but we're not always fully present to the Eucharist, to God present among us. We can listen to a friend in need without truly feeling invested. Oftentimes, those situations in our life are a physical choice, and it's not wrong. But in our hearts, we need to turn with great love to recognize Jesus, to recognize those most in need right in front of us. What does it take for us to make that turn a second time? A turn that's not purely physical, but a turn of the heart. Let us stand now and offer our prayers to God, our Heavenly Father, for Pope Francis and Bishop Bambera, and all those who lead the church, that they may always serve by example those most in need. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those in Israel and the Ukraine and all countries that are torn by war and strife, that peace may be sought during these difficult times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all men and women in the military, both at home and overseas, and all first responders in our local community, that they may always be kept safe from harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the protection of life from conception to natural death, that all people may respect the dignity and sanctity of human life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, may they come to know eternal peace in God's heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we gather here this day and ask that you hear and answer these prayers which we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of God's holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings presented in commemoration of Saint Mary Magdalene, whose homage of charity was graciously accepted by your own begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Mary Jo Spellman, Mary Rose Williams, and Robert Remsky, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress,
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the holy reception of your mysteries, Lord, instill in us that persevering love with which St. Mary Magdalene clung resolutely to Christ, her Master, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day, everyone.